Hello students, in this lecture we will discuss about lattice vibrations of one-dimensional diatomic lattice. In the last lecture we have discussed about the lattice vibrations of one-dimensional monoatomic lattice. The link of that lecture is given in the description below. You may watch that lecture again. In this lecture, suppose there are a chain of atoms having two different masses m1 and m2. m1 is bigger than m2. And in the case when the chain is at equilibrium, the position of M1 is US and position of M2 is VS. After some displacement, we observe that M1 displaced up to US, from this place up to this place, and we call this distance US, and M2 displaced from its equilibrium position to this point, and we call this distance VS. Please remember that in this case, the unit cell equals 2a, and that is the distance between mass m1 up to the same mass m1. And this unit cell keeps two atoms. One atom is m2, and another atom is half of this mass and half of this mass. So, number of atoms per primitive unit cell equals 2. And as we supposed that two atoms having masses m1 and m2, where m1 is bigger than m2. US is the displacement of m1 and VS is the displacement of m2. Now, equation of motion for m1 using Hooke's law, that supposed to be FUS proportional US minus VS, that is for the right side, and for the left side, FUS proportional to VS minus 1 minus US. Now, taking the net displacement, we get X equals VS minus 1 plus VS minus 2 US. Using the Hooke's law, F equals CX, by putting X expression over here, we get, by using then the Newton's second law, M1 derivative of US with second derivative of US with respect to time equals C into this term. Let's call this equation number 1. Now, using the same steps for finding the equation of motion for M2, and for the case of M2, FVS proportional VS minus US plus 1 for the right side, and for the left side, we get FVS proportional US minus VS. Now, by taking the net displacement, we get this expression, and by putting this expression in the Hooke's law, we get M2 second derivative of VS with respect to time equals C into this expression. Let's call this equation number 2. Now we have two equations, equation number 1 for mass M1 and equation 2 for mass M2. Now, we want to guess the solution for these second order differential equations. Suppose US equals UE power iota ksa minus iota omega t is the solution of equation 1, and Vs equals V e power iota ksa minus iota omega t. Now, taking the second order derivative of US and also the second order derivative of Vs, and also making the expression for US plus 1 and Vs minus 1, Vs plus 1, and then putting in equation 2, you get this expression, which further by simplifying, we get equation number 3, and that is minus m1 omega square u equals all of this expression. And in the similar way, we can also get the expression for mass m2, and that is minus m2 omega square v equals this expression. So now we have equation number 3 and 4. By rearranging 3 and 4, and keeping them in matrix form, we can find a non-trivial solution, and that would be 2c minus m omega square into 2c minus m2 omega square minus c square into this expression along with this equals 0. By doing some steps and using the quadratic equation, we get omega square equals c into this expression along with plus minus of this expression. And that is nothing but dispersion relation for diatomic lattice. Now, we can go for two cases. First case keeping lambda very longer means long wavelength case. And for that, as we already know that k must be equal to zero. So this is the way we can now simplify equation five, and that would be omega square equals this expression, having two values now, with one with positive sign, another one is with negative sign. So for positive value, omega square equals this expression, where we just put the positive sign over here, showing that we are getting this expression for the positive sign. And this frequency is for the optical branch. I'll explain optical branch later, but let's at this moment just keep in your mind that omega plus is equal to this expression, and that belongs to optical branch. For the negative value, we get omega minus square equals zero, which further omega minus equals zero. And please remember, this minus is just only because of this minus sign, and that is for the expression of acoustical branch. Now we have two values, one for the positive, two expressions of the frequencies, one for the positive value and second one for the negative value. Now by considering the second case, where k equals plus minus pi over a, putting this k value in the equation number five and doing some steps, finally we get this expression, having plus minus both signs, keeping the positive value first, we get omega square equals to c over m1, which further can be written like omega plus equals to c over m1 under root. That is for optical branch. And for the negative value, we get omega minus equals to c over m2 under root. That is for acoustical branch. I hope you still remembered from the last lecture that in monoatomic lattice, there was one value of omega for one value of k. But in case of a diatomic, we have two different values of omega. So because positive sign represents the optical branch of wave, and negative sign representing the acoustical branch. Let's focus again on equation number four, which one was minus m2 omega square v equals this expression. Write this equation in terms of u or v. U over v equals 2c minus m2 omega square over c into e power eta k a plus 1. Let's call this equation number 6. Now, by using this expression, we are going to get some very nice results. I'll explain all of those results one by one. Before that, let's talk about the dispersion relation of diatomic lattice. That looks like this, where we have a caustic branch, allowed energy band, and we have optical branch that is also allowed energy band, but there is forbidden band between both. No phonon exists in frequency gap, which, and please remember, this frequency gap depends on the masses m1 and m2. So you can simply say that no phonon exists in frequency gap, and frequency gap depends on both masses. You can simply take the difference and you can see if masses are same, there is no gap, and that should be the case like monoatomic lattice. And you can also simply say bandwidth of allowed energy band equals 2c over m2 under root omega minus, that belongs to acoustic branch, and bandwidth of allowed energy band equals this term, that belongs to optical branch. Hence, allowed frequency bandwidth for propagation of waves split into two branches, optical branch and acoustic branch. And there is a frequency gap that is proportional to mt over m1 under root. If m1 increases, gap decreases. You can see this from this expression. And if m2 increases, gap increases. And if both masses are equal, gap disappears. So, as we already discussed in the last lecture, that in case of monoatomic lattice, we get only acoustic branch. But in case of diatomic lattice, we get both optical and acoustic. Here are two very important concepts which I want to explain. First one is about optical branch. In optical branch, there must be two atoms per unit cell, and both will move in opposite directions. Hence, center of mass in optical branch remains fixed. If plus showing one of the mass, negative showing another mass, then they will move in opposite directions to each other. But the center of mass in optical branch remains fixed. In acoustic branch, center of mass is not fixed. It moves with atoms. You see, plus, minus, plus, minus, if atoms are moving, so center of mass is also moving. There is experimental evidence for the optical case. For example, NaCl, where sodium and chlorine have different masses. Masses are different, but the center of mass remains fixed. Let's come back to the equation number 6. I'll explain the dispersion relation for diatomic lattice again by using this equation for both cases, acoustic branch and an optical branch. Let's first focus on acoustic branch. As k ranges from 0 up to plus minus pi over a, for the first Brillouin zone, we have two possible cases. Case 1, for k tends to 0, means limit k tends to 0, omega tends to 0. So now equation number 6 becomes u over v equals 2c over c and into e power 0 plus 1, that equals to 1. Hence, u equals v. And I hope you remember, u is the displacement of mass m1 and v was the displacement of mass m2. What does this expression mean? It means at k equals 0, both atoms in the unit cell have same amplitudes for acoustic branch. Now for the second case, k tends to plus minus pi over a, equation 6 becomes u over v equals this expression. And by using the Euler identity, e power iota pi equals minus 1, we get u over v equals infinite. And if we just do the cross multiplication, we get v over u equals 0, where v equals 0. What does this mean? It means that the smaller atoms are stationary in acoustic branch. Now we will focus on optical branch. Because this is the upper branch corresponding to the positive sign of dispersion relation. So for the case 1, you remember from the previous slides, omega plus square equals this expression, where when we keep k equals plus minus pi over a, we get omega plus minimum. This expression, which representing minimum allowed values of omega. Now, from this expression, let's work on equation 6 again. U over v equals this term, where we just replace omega by this expression, we get u over v equals 0. It means u equals 0. Now, what does this mean? It means that the heavy mass is at rest in optical branch. Okay. So now, for the next case, using the equation 6, u over v equals this one. Case 2, k equals 0, the maximum allowed values of omega plus equals this expression. So now putting this expression in equation number 6, we get u over v equals this one. By simplifying, we get u over v equals minus m2 or m1. Now this expression means that the ratio of motion of masses equals to the ratio of the masses, where negative sign indicates that heavy mass moves out of phase with respect to lighter mass. Okay, now based on the results of equation 6, we want to explain again the dispersion relation. At k equals 0, we found that both masses vibrate with the same amplitude. But at k equals plus minus pi over a, in the acoustic branch, lighter mass remains at rest, but the heavy masses are vibrating. And at optical branch, exactly at minus pi over a, the heavy mass remains at rest, but the lighter masses are vibrating. And at k is equal, Okay, now we have four results based on equation number six. And I want to explain all of these four results in dispersion relation. Let's focus first on acoustic branch. Where at k equals zero, we found that both masses will vibrate with the same amplitude. And k equals plus minus pi over a, the lighter mass will be at rest, but heavy masses will vibrate. And at k equals zero, we found that in optical branch, the both masses will be out of phase to each other. And at k equals plus minus pi over a, in optical branch, the heavy mass will be at rest, but lighter masses will vibrate.